This is a guided meditation into self-inquiry. Self-inquiry is the practice of observing the observer. There are no prerequisites to practice this reflection. It is religionless and timeless. There are no steps. Likewise, there is no guide, not even this meditation, that can bring you to the realization of yourself within. It is immediate. It is instant. This clear seeing can happen even now. Start with a few natural breaths. If it helps to do so, close your eyes. And to begin this meditation, we're going to start with a short reading from the book Who Dies by Stephen and Andrea Levine. We have gotten so used to looking outside of ourselves that we have forgotten to ask who it is that's looking. We participate in our natural spaciousness so seldom. When we think of dying, we think of losing who we are. We will no longer be able to be this or that which we imagine ourselves to be. Yet if we pay close attention, we notice that whenever we say, "I am this," or "I am that," there is to some degree a feeling of being an imposter. That whenever the "I am" of just being is attached to this or that in the world, there's a feeling of falsity, of incompleteness, of somehow not quite telling the whole truth. When I say I am happy, or I am sad, I am smart, or I am fair, we see that all the things we attach to this "I am" are constantly in change. So there's nothing in the universe of change that I can call myself for very long. Nothing I can say that I am is the whole truth. In fact, much of the time, we feel like we are pretending to be someone else simply by pretending to be anything at all. But we notice that when we simply say, "I am," that there's just space, just being. That this "I" does not refer to something separate, to something outside of ourselves, or even to the body or the mind. It is just a sense of presence, of being. When you say, "I am," and when I say, "I am," we are referring to the same being. Everybody's "I" is the same "I." Who is this "I"? Or put another way, who do you think you are? Without judgment or filtration of thought, bring to the surface of your mind a picture of who you perceive yourself to be. And just breathe. Examine this question of who are you? What is this image? What descriptions appear? What titles or roles? How seriously do you take this identity? How many times has this description or image changed? What is being added to the pure "I am"? For example, "I am sad," or "I am stressed," "I am a man," "I am a woman." Who is it that is these things? These are accessories and labels for the mind. But what remains? Watch these accessories, these labels, like luggage, float naturally and drift effortlessly a bit into the distance. Not denying or pushing the emotions or identities away, just observing. Getting curious and getting some distance to observe from a new perspective. Because we've so tightly associated ourselves with our thoughts, behaviors, and beliefs. We rarely question these appearances and disappearances. This question, who am I? Who is asking this question? Seek this out for yourself, without confirming with someone else if it is true. At the most basic level, you are here. You exist. You are pure awareness, the witness of all that comes and goes, appears and disappears. You observe it all. Continue to come back to the breath. Use it as an anchor. You are not your mind. You are not your body. You are not your gender or role or past or future. Not your morals or your beliefs. You are not any of these things either. Make no division or classification of who you are as opposed to who you are not. These are all occurrences, temporary showings. Allow them, be with them, notice them, feel them, but you do not need to be them. And when tangled in a web of illusion, one can always ask the question, but who am I? And return to this foundation. This reply, I am.